Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to create multiple lines of animated text with just one layer. No alpha mats, no solids, no shape layers, and no plugins. This text is animated using just one text layer and some keyframes and a mask. And you can save this as a preset and bring it into any project with the click of a button. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's create a new composition. Just click our new comp icon here, and we'll call this animated text. And just leave this a 1920 by 1080, and let's make this 15 seconds long. Click OK. And I'm just going to create a quick background, so Control Y, and this dark gray is just fine. So Control T to bring up our text tool, and let's just type 7-minute AE tutorials. So let's right-click on the text layer, go to Transform, go to Center, Anchor Point, and Layer Content, or Control-Alt-Home, and then open up our Align panel and just center this text up like that. Okay, so let's open up our text layer here, and we want to go to our Animate option here, and let's add a position. Let's rename this animator POS1. So let's duplicate POS1. So now we have POS2. Now we can close up this first position. We're not even going to need that anymore. All the animation is going to be coming from this position too. So if we open up our range selector, we see that we have some options here. The first thing we need to do is we need to figure out how we want this to animate in. I'm going to animate this from the bottom to the middle and then from the middle to the top. Position 2 is going to be where your text begins. So let's just move our position down like this. And then the offset is what's going to actually be animating this text. So if we put a keyframe at our 0 point, go forward a second, go up to 100%, we can see that that animates in by character. And this may be the kind of animation that you want. I want to do it actually by word. So the way you do that, open up this advanced tab and just change this based on characters to based on words. You can even choose based on lines. We're going to choose based on words. So if we watch that, we see how it comes up one word at a time. Okay, so I'm going to zoom in here a little bit. Let's highlight these keyframes, right click, and choose Easy Ease. First, let's change our shape from square to ramp up. And as you can see, this already changes the way our animation moves. Whenever you use ramp up, your offset range is going to be negative 100 to 100. So I'm going to go down to my ease high. I'm going to move that up to 100%. So that should ease it in a little bit more and pull these keyframes together. I'm going to hit end to loop that. And so now we have something that's kind of like that. I'm going to slow it down a little bit. Grab our rectangle tool. I'm just going to draw a rectangle around our text. So open up our mask or hit F to bring up your feather. And let's just make that feather about 5 pixels. And as you scrub through, you can see how much feathering you have. So you may want to adjust that depending on the look you're going for. Actually make this 10. And as we can see, my position isn't down far enough. So go back to position 2 and just lower this position down until it's underneath your mask. So I want it to come up and then I want it to hold for maybe about a second or half a second. And then I want it to animate up. So the way we animate it up, we need to add another position. So go to your animate button and add position. And we'll call this POS3. And let's open up POS3. One of the things to remember whenever you use text animators is that each text animator interacts with the previous one. So this position 3 doesn't really interact with position 1. It only interacts with position 2. So let's open up our advanced option here. Instead of square, we're going to do ramp down instead of ramp up. And we also want to use ease low instead of ease high. So let's put ease low to 100%. Okay, and now let's move our position for position 3 to the place where we want it to end. So let's just pull this up. And now we need to add some keyframes. So let's go to offset and add a keyframe for negative 100. So that way it stays here in the middle. And then go forward a little bit. And then we want to crank up to 100. And now as you can see, it's animating our characters up. Well, that's because these always default to based on characters. So make sure you change this to based on words. So what we have now is this. Your source text is what actually controls which characters make up your text. So we can click that and see we get a toggle hold keyframe, and then we can change this. So say like if I say with Jeff Knight. Now see, it won't change until you get to the keyframe, but that's how you change the text. If you hit U to bring up your keyframes, first let's go ahead and make these Easy Ease keyframes. So now if you select this first keyframe, hold down Shift, and then select your second keyframe, right click and choose toggle hold keyframe. So you want your second keyframes to be toggle hold keyframes. And then you just want to go beyond where the animation stops bring over your next source text keyframe, and then we just need to add a few more keyframes here. Our offset ends at 100% on both of these. So if we highlight these first two, Control C, Control V, so that way we have the same keyframes here. Go forward, and then the same thing for our second set of keyframes, Control C, Control V. You'll see that this doesn't quite get us where we want to be. So we have to make sure that our values for these offset keyframes are the same for each subsequent animation. So again, if we go back to the beginning, we'll see that our offset begins at negative 100 and it ends at 100. Whenever we get to this next keyframe, now we'll see our first offset is negative 100. Our second one is 100. Highlight this keyframe here, Control C, Control V, to make that negative 100. And if we watch it back, we can see that this has the desired effect. And then once you establish that, all you have to do is highlight these keyframes, Control C, go down to wherever you want to animate in again, Control V. And you can just do this as many times as you want. And in between the animations is where you want to change your text. So see, first you have to see what your text is. So you can type your text anywhere in here. So we'll say After Effects Tutorial, and then just move this keyframe in between our animations, which this next one occurs about right here. Let's see, that's Jeff Knight. It animates off, and then when we come here and we have After Effects Tutorial, we'll say no alpha mats. And again, we want to move that in between our animation, just one layer and a mask, and move that in between these animations. This is a super easy way to animate text off and on, especially if you have a lot of text that you need to animate in this way. And the really cool thing about this, let's close up this layer. If we open it back up, we want to choose our text, mask, and transform. So highlight all of those. Go to Animation, Save Animation Preset. So on PC, you want to go to Documents, Adobe, 2019 User Presets. And I'm going to put this, I have a folder for text animation. I'm just going to call this Infinite Text Loop and then just hit Save. Now let's get rid of this text layer, create another one, and you can just type anything in here. It doesn't matter what you type, just type nothing. Make sure your playhead is at the beginning of this layer. Go over to your Effects and Presets and go to your User Presets and find that folder where we just save that text animation, double click Infinite Text Loop. We see that our mask came back in. If you hit U, all of our keyframes came back in and we can watch it and it has everything set exactly the way that we saved it. So now I have this preset forever. I never have to create it again. And the next time I have an infographic with a lot of text, I can bring this in and change it out instantaneously. I hope this helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. I've included the project file in the description below, and I'd love to hear your feedback about this course and any other topic you'd like to see covered. Don't forget to be on the lookout for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers, coming very soon. I'll give you more information about this course in the coming weeks. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time.